Hi, welcome to a new video. This is Daryl Talks About New Zealand channel. And so in my channel, I've been talking about a few infrastructure projects. So I've talked about ultra-fast broadband, and I've talked about highways that are being made in the Wellington area, because those are the highways that I use all the time. So quite interested in new developments in roading around the capital of New Zealand. The next project that I'm talking about is the project to bring electric cars into New Zealand. And we have a government that has been a little bit hands-off with us, just kind of letting the market come to pass. What we have in New Zealand is a really good source of electricity. So unlike our neighbours Australia, who produce most of their electricity from fossil fuels like coal, in New Zealand, for a long time, we've produced most of our electricity from renewable energy. And in fact, we've almost always produced all of our electricity in New Zealand from renewable energy. Coal and gas production of electricity in New Zealand is very minimal. We don't really have much in the way of CO2 coming from our electricity supply. I think at a near a maximum of 20% of our electricity comes from coal and gas, and most of the time nowhere near that. Most of the time probably only a few percent, like maybe 5% or 3% or close to 1% of electricity is coming from coal or gas, or in some cases diesel. So as you can see, we already have a lot of renewables. New Zealand being in the roaring 40s latitude, we have a lot of wind power. So wind power was our second phase of renewable energy, whereas our first phase of renewable energy was hydropower. In the 1950s, 60s, 70s and 80s and 90s, I guess, there were a lot of hydropower plants being produced in New Zealand. And then after the hydro power started to get, well, they ran out of spaces to really produce more dams, we moved on to having wind power. So there's been wind power plants being built right up until now. I'm not quite sure of any wind power projects that are being produced at the moment, but in the last decade, there've been a few wind power farms made. There's huge wind farm near Palmerston North, and you can see it all along the hillside if you go near Palmerston North or Woodville. And in Wellington, there's a huge wind power plant which was made in two phases, which is, I think it's called the West Wind Power Farm. And that wind farm can produce enough electricity generally to run everything in Wellington. And since Wellington's the capital, our sort of second or third largest city, that's quite a significant amount of electricity being produced there. But the other form of renewable energy that people don't really talk about in New Zealand is geothermal energy. And around 15%, perhaps a little bit more, of our electricity comes from geothermal electricity production. What's great about geothermal production is the system runs 24 hours per day. So it's a base load source of electricity. So one of the problems you have in electricity production is with wind power, the wind doesn't blow constantly all of the time. But in New Zealand, we do get quite a lot of good breezy days most of the time. So there's always a sort of almost a normal general base load of wind power. But the base load electricity in New Zealand, it comes from primarily hydro, then geothermal, and then the things that aren't really base load. So we have gas-fired peak plants, which will operate just some days when the demand for electricity is very high. And the coal power plant at Huntly will operate. It operates all the time, but they ramp it up and ramp it down. So if they know that there's going to be a spell of really cold weather then they'll bring more coal power online. And then if there's sudden surge demand for electricity, use gas. I guess one of the good things about wind power in New Zealand is it's often windy when the weather is bad. When there's demand for more home heating, it's often windy. Hydropower and geothermal power runs all the time. There's no reason to shut that down for any sort of weather condition or anything like that. So that's great. So that was a recap of the New Zealand electricity market, so that we know that we have good energy for supplying electricity to electric cars. I'm going to break the video here, and in the second part, I'm going to talk about electric cars that are available in New Zealand and look at the kind of car that I want to buy. So thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe, and we'll see the next part shortly.